Let's move on to the Maza family. That's the name of the wine. It's also Cabernet Sauvignon based, and primarily Cabernet Sauvignon. This is vintage 2015, so it's 1 year older. Second label, second wine of the Changyu Maza estate. Definitely a little bit more denser color here straight away, but it's not massive. It's not like your big Napa Valley Cabernet Sauvignon or Aussie Cabernet Sauvignon. It's much milder in appearance, more like a Bordeaux looking wine. The nose is also very interesting. Still a lot of oak. This smells like an evolved wine, a wine that may have spent quite a long time in barrel, may have evolved and integrated quite a lot of oak, somewhat in a Rioja style, Rioja Gran Reserva or Rioja Reserva style, where you can sense that this is a generous fruit that spent a long time in oak. But a very fruity, again, very spicy nose, fruity blackberry, lots of pungent flavors, lots of pepper. This is about a $30 wine. I mean, the price is going to vary whether depending where you buy this, whether it's in Hong Kong or mainland China, in the US or in Europe, if you can find it, obviously, but I think it's around $30. The tannins are denser and smoother. It's actually very well balanced. It's round, it's soft, it's creamy, it's dry. This is definitely on the Bordeaux style, Bordeaux savoriness. Not entirely just on the full-bodied and rich expression. There is some generosity from the big amount of sunshine that these grapes receive, but it's on the savory European old-school style, claret style for the UK audience. So soft, well-rounded wines, lots of complexity, pepperiness, spices and clove and nutmeg, black pepper, an explosion of sweet spices. There's actually quite a lot going on here. Certainly they've achieved an excellent balance in this wine. Big ups to the winemakers making this, because it's a very European expression. It's very controlled, it's balanced and soft on your palate. This to me is a 90 out of 100 points wine. So this is getting really, really serious. This is really getting into the low end but world-class wines, and I guess that's what you expect if you spend $30 on a wine. But compared to many French wines, definitely compared to a lot of US wines, you are getting a refined, well-crafted Cabernet Sauvignon for the bucks here. I am actually very surprised at how European this feels. Put this in a blind tasting. If you can find this and you have friends and you want to surprise them at a blind tasting, put that in a blind tasting and let me know what they think it was. I wouldn't be surprised if they were going definitely European, Southern European, Bordeaux in a very warm vintage, 2009 vintage sort of wine perhaps, 2015. But yeah, very well rounded wine, excellent value at $30. Wow, getting worried that the Chinese might play in the international wine scene very, very soon. Actually, I'm not worried at all. I think the Chinese and everyone else should come and play in the international wine scene. The more players, the more enjoyment, the more choice we can get. So I'm not actually worried at all. It's just joking right here.